This is the scene that we're going to be painting at, on a value scale. And this is the start of a French church. And what I'm doing is I'm blocking in the sky on a dry paper with a neutral tint, getting it as dark as I think it should be in one area, and then using the brush and softening some of the edges. And then as I proceed along with my brush, I'm going to put these trees that go across the front of the church. And there's a bridge also, as you can see in the picture up in the upper right. And I'll put that in basically as one shape. Try to think of it as shape and not a bridge. And then I'm starting to put in the roofs of the houses. And these give the scale that you have to have in this in order to see how big that church is. So you don't want to eliminate these houses. But you don't have to do them exactly how you see them either. And so I've just taken my brush and taken some water off of that and going in front now across the top part of the bridge. And it's a little darker value. As I work, I proceed from dark to from light to dark, and that's what I'm doing right now. Is just trying to put in some darks and feel my way through this particular painting. And you know, sometimes you think, well, that's not really the way you want to do it, but then you just go with your instinct, and then keep working for what you. What you accomplish. And so I'm going to be now looking at bringing in some more little highlights and windows in these buildings. Once you put a dark dash, it's a window, and then that becomes a house. And now we've got a wall that goes right in front of the cathedral there. And then also there's trees on the bank of the river. And so I'm going to putting that in. And very quickly, big bold strokes. And now I'm going.
Now what I'm doing is I'm establishing the dark shadow of the bridge
in the picture
on the water.
That down there. Then there's a lighter area
also bringing
the rest of it
same value
all the way across.
Value to make it as simple as
middle value
as possible. Dark value
with
and just a few values at stake. Simplicity is the.
Okay, there we go.
The essence to this type of painting. And so you want to block everything in that as a shape.
Sort of
and then go in for
a feeling my way way through it. I know I need some vertical highlights.
The volume or the dimension of that
and shape. So now I'm going to start saying, okay, I got
now
my
for
background,
the star of the
my secondary actors
matter
in the scene
of the
now
church.
I'm going to put the star.
I'm putting in the
so I'm going to start now
the roof.
The roof
and
on.
Basically, I think I really should could
and,
have this as one particular
gently
value, but in the process of doing this, and this is why you do sketches like this, because then you can analyze how you would do the painting. And in this case, I would paint this entire church as a light value throughout everything. Now what I'm doing is I'm just picking out the darkest areas of the church, the steeple and that type of thing. If you look at the church itself compared to the clouds, it is darker than the clouds, so it's not as light. And so just keep that in mind when you do it, is that it should be just one silhouette of a light value, and then the roof can be put on as a darker value. But let's continue on how I'm doing it here. Putting in some of the dark marks that I see, and then work from there. Now I'm going to put a little bit of another value, a little bit lighter. Now you see that value should really have been all the way across, but I'm saving some whites in the church to show the highlight, and then of course then I'm painting the roof. Of this octagon shape in front of the church, and just actually what I'm doing too is squinting
at the church and see exactly how dark it is, and also simplifying. Now we've got these trees that are going in front, and of course the picture shows them very orderly, and I don't want them orderly. I want them sort of, they're the foil between the church and the riverbank, and so I'm just putting marks randomly throughout and connecting these marks, but fairly dark, and then putting in some trunks that will hold them up. They're almost like, you can think of umbrellas with a pole between. Okay, now I've established some of the darks within the composition, and so now I'm going to go ahead and with my brush, I'll just go ahead and start putting some of the darks inside, looking at the photo, and then some of the vertical lines that have the bridge, and then putting a few little darker marks down there. That's working out well. So now I have to do some structure underneath that bridge, and so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make it darker right underneath it. I think that'll bring out the post that's holding up that bridge. And there's a cast shadow that goes across the bridge also. Okay, then I'm going with the trees, the bank, separate the bank now from the water itself. And I'm squinting at the photo to see exactly where that is. There's my cast shadow that goes across the top. And so it shows a little bit of more of a dimension there. I have another little house right in that area. So you can see the house and the roofs are all kind of joining into the trees, which is good. They're not completely isolated. They're merging as one shape. Okay, just keep painting and looking to see what can I cover with another value to unify this composition. I got a little dark up in the cathedral there, and a little bit on the roof. Just these little touches always help out. And you know, you don't want to do them too soon. If I'd have taken that dark there before the steeple, that would have been way too bad, too dark. Now it isn't, because it's compared to the value of the steeple. Okay, just a little bit more there. Now I think what I should do is sort of get some unity to this bridge here. So I'm going to use a little darker shadow coming up in there, and then we've got the foliage or the bank of leaves that's in front, and make sure you can show that by contrast, by painting the negative space. I know there's a reflection there and it's hard to see. But that's what I'm doing. And then I'm going to go in and continually with this whole thing. Now this whole bank is sort of there's too much light in it. And there's too much light on top, and there's too much light, patches of light in the cathedral. So I have to do away with one of those. And I think the bank is what should go. So what I'm going to do is get the water first, get that down a little bit darker, and come across there, just make that just a little darker. Now it's starting to relate. And then I'm darkening now the roof, bringing that dark a little bit darker. And now I'm using my rigger
that will give me some sketchy lines, call them like broken line, on the cathedral, and also as the cathedral goes down below the trees and into the roof lines and so forth, drawing them as, you know, as sketchy as I possibly can, instead of trying to be a draftsman. So it becomes really basically a painting, not a an illustration. And I'm still going to darken just a little bit there, and putting that down. You see these dark lines, they add to the dimension, but you don't want to do too many of them, but they start bringing everything into focus and give interest. A little bit more of sketchy lines in the foliage and the bank. I've got some branches that are coming out before, and I indicated some leaves, and now I'm just putting in some branches up in that area so that there's an ending to the pictorial picture of this, instead of just going off somewhere else. It's sort of a closure, and then I'm going to darken that just a little bit. Now I'm going to take some of that white that's down below, and you can see what happens when I do that. Then I, you know, leave a little bit, and then also I'm going to darken that up a little bit. So as the reflection of the bridge, and I think that's done. Thank you for watching.